Blue versus Five Blinks, and they face elimination in the lower bracket, and you couldn't ask for a better matchup. Five Blinks come out guns blazing on their main composition, the Rogue, Mage, Priest, and the move, of course. I don't even need to say it's their main composition. It's almost just the only composition that they need. Shadow Priest, Rogue, Restoration, Shaman. Early on, we see WizK posted up in midfield setting up. Both Rogues in stealth, looking to try and find each other if they can deny some opening pressure from the Assassination Rogue. Vault's winning the initial exchange against WizK, most certainly.
He has some backup.
I mean, of course, he has some backup. It's effectively 2-on-1. So Abster just decided that this mid-game play is not going to be a good trade for them, so they're going to push up. The move look to start the fight, but Nesper counter-engages.
Yep, Nesper's going to be opening up on all three members. What are they going to do? One of the strengths of the Arcane Mage is some of the Azerite traits they have available to them, including Quick Thinking, which basically every time Volts uses an instant cast spell, he gets a little bit of a heal. Now, this actually works quite well with the Discipline Priest, as their throughput isn't that great, but when you have one member of your team who's healing himself up a lot during the match, makes Volts just not a great target to really go after. I'd be surprised if the move decide that that's their main target of choice in this matchup. The Arcane Mage is just so slippery. The amount of self-healing he has makes him really difficult to take down. So this battle could come down to a mana war, quite frankly.
Ooh, smoke bomb attempt here by Nesper onto Peekaboo. Absurge looks like he's more than ready. He had Tremor Totem preemptively down when he ran into the smoke bomb to avoid a psychic scream from the Disciplined Priest. It looks like the move actually switching to the Disciplined Priest, trying to gun him down. Let's see how well Zin deals with the pressure here against the move in game number one. Very low on health. Peekaboo going for the kill, interrupting Shadow Mend. If Abstract can follow up with a Wind Shear. Doesn't look like they want to stay on Zin for now, waiting for that powered barrier, blinding him at low health. This has to be game. I actually don't think there's any way he survives if he gets sapped. They may not even need the sap. They go for the silence. They go for the cheap shot. The move get the stun out and immediately
goodness.
Owned. That was a classic. I mean, that was very similar.
Combination of the Restoration Druid with the Holy Paladin worked out well against basically everything. I mean, it seemed like they had a fair shot, and that's kind of how the move has always played the game. Like, maybe they aren't compositionally advantaged, but as long as they have a fair shot, they can find windows of opportunity to make it work. So I think for Absturge, it's going to be really important to diversify off the Restoration Shaman, play the Holy Paladin, play the Restoration Druid. As long as the game is in a similar spot, if he can have all those three healers under his belt, then I think the combination of Peekaboo and WizK can really excel.
Volt's getting crowd control on Absturge early on, pressure on WizK as a result. Continuing the chain once again, WizK wants to go after the Discipline Priest. They just want to kill the healer, but he's quite overextended while Absurge sits through a long crowd control chain. They're going all in on WizK. Many defensive cooldowns exchanged early on, perhaps all of them, or simply death. WizK has to use Dispersion on top of everything else. The move, they're playing aggressive. They wanted to go all in for a kill on the Discipline Priest. It cost them their whole lineup, but maybe it doesn't matter. Perhaps Peekaboo can just kill Zin within seconds of this match starting. Multiple Gladiator's Maledicts incoming. Zin dispels them, but with Vampiric Touch, horrifies himself. Defensive blind on Nesper to deny sort of safety here to save Zin, his priest. Any more interrupts and Zin falls. Volts moves back to support Frost Nova. Psychic Scream to bait dispel. Abstergs gets swapped to and bursted down by Nesper. Perhaps very low. That was actually the Void Shift of Wiz. Okay, Zin is still just getting tunneled.
Good night.
Move are going all in on the Discipline Priest, and it is such a struggle for him to stay alive facing the move.
Bit of an extra punch in the opener, because I feel like they've realized they really can't live that long.
I think he just switched it at the last second there. So.
Oh, all right. Well, I was wrong.
Zin, maybe on Tolvaron with a big open field, can stay away from Peekaboo. Perhaps they focus Peekaboo and try and shut him down, because he's really the initiator to get the kill on their Discipline Priest. If they can crowd control him or target him down sooner, then perhaps they can save their Discipline Priest. Although it looks like WizK is going to be the starting target. Volts is moving across midfield. Peekaboo probably sees Volts and is either going to look to disrupt him, which he does with Kick, or push forward towards Zin and build momentum. So Peekaboo interrupts Polymorph, then immediately switches over to Zin and goes for a kill there. WizK in Void Form is going to be doing a lot of damage. Zin using the Human Racial to get out of the stun right away, but it was not really... I guess it is the commitment of the Vendetta. It's a fair trade on Zin's part. Smoke Bomb dropped by Nesper, looking to create some momentum here onto WizK. They stun Absurge on the Trinket. Well done. WizK in a bit of trouble as Gladiator's Maledicts are incoming and absorbing a lot of healing onto him. Abster just powering through it, though. No significant cooldown exchange yet through the start of this fight, but likely now with a full polymorph dispersion on Wizkay will allow him to recover. Nesper, the target of Peekaboo, as he is trying to stall and protect Wizkay. Perhaps we see that defensive blind again so that they can find the kill onto Zinn, but Zinn has not really overcommitted his defensive cooldowns. He's in a much better position. He's just staying away from the fight, focused on his own survival and letting his team do all the work. But now Nesper gets swapped to and bursted down, caught in a stunny pre-cloak of shadows. The incoming smoke bomb decides to trinket in evasion anyway, respecting that line of sight blocker on his priest. Full polymorph from Zinn, but mass dispelled by Wizkay. Barrier traded out as well, so a bit of an overcommitment here from Five Blinks. You can tell that Zinn, he might be either panicking or tilting at this point on match point. Big damage on Nesper.
Oh, no.
Tons of pressure, perhaps facing elimination within seconds from now.
Yeah, Zinn throws out Pain Suppression. That's Pain Suppression. Archangel, Powered Barrier, Evasion, Cloak of Shadows, all within 10 seconds of each other. Five Blinks is running out of time. There's not too many defensive cooldowns left. One nice crowd control chain from the team of the move will eventually take down Nesper here if they still decide to go with him. Zinn's just positioned so far away right now, it's really difficult. Silence into Kidney Shot. The Leap of Faith will keep Nesper alive for just a short period of time, but that blind on the relentless trinket choice of Zinn, that's it. The move advanced 3-0.
Yeah, they even used
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.